Have you ever noticed a message saying your CR Basic program compiled in pipeline or sequential mode? You might see it in the CR Basic Editor compile results or when you send a program to the data logger. Hi, I'm Collin Daly from Campbell Scientific in Logan, Utah. In this video, I'll explain the different compile modes, sequential and pipeline, and their advantages. By default, your CR Basic program will try to compile in pipeline mode. It will automatically switch to sequential mode when necessary. There are also instructions that will force the program to compile in one mode or the other. Let's start with a more straightforward mode, sequential mode. The CR Basic Editor help offers this description for the sequential mode instruction. In sequential mode, instructions are executed by the data logger sequentially as they occur in the program. In other words, your program runs from top to bottom. You can also think of sequential mode like this, with one instruction being executed after another. Sequential mode gives you control over the order in which instructions are executed and makes your program easy to follow. Sequential mode is especially useful when you are powering sensors under program control. That way you are sure your sensor is turned on at the correct time. In sequential mode, each measurement is followed by the processing task it requires. In other words, measurements and processing do not occur concurrently. Instead, processing always follows the measurement. Here we have three measurements, A, B, and C. Each measurement needs processing shown by PA, PB, and PC. In this simple example, processing includes applying multipliers and offsets and performing output calculations. We also see that there is some idle time in the scan, the white squares. Idle time is created when the data logger has completed all its tasks before the scan interval time elapses. In other words, it takes less time to complete its tasks than the scan interval. If we remove the idle time in the scan, the fastest this set of measurements and processing could run in sequential mode would be a scan rate of 6 seconds. We are using seconds in our example, but in fact, Campbell Scientific data loggers can run much faster at sub-second intervals. Trying to run the scan any faster in sequential mode would result in skip scans, or you could get a skip scan if the occasional processing task takes longer than you've accounted for. Check to see if there are any skip scans by viewing the station status in PC400 or in the LoggerNet Connect screen. It should be noted that the CR350 and CR300 series data loggers always run in sequential mode. Now, let's take a look at pipeline mode. The CR Basic Editor help offers this description for pipeline mode instruction. In pipeline mode, measurement tasks and processing tasks are handled separately and executed concurrently. In pipeline mode, measurement tasks are given the highest priority so that they execute first with precise timing in each scan. However, processing tasks don't have to be done at a precise time and can be completed later, even during a different scan if the data logger has a tight time schedule. The ability to make and process measurements concurrently is accomplished by using scan buffers that allow processing tasks to queue up and occur in the background while measurements are being made. Here is the same program we looked at in the sequential mode example, but this time it is running in pipeline mode. Once again, there are three measurements, A, B, and C, with the processing of the measurements PA, PB, and PC. Because we are using pipeline mode, the measurement and processing tasks are handled separately but can occur concurrently. Now let's speed things up. In the sequential mode example, the fastest we could run the program without getting skip scans was 6 seconds. But in pipeline mode, measurements and processing happen concurrently as needed, which allows us to increase the scan rate to 5 seconds. And by removing all idle time, it could run every 3 seconds. Another thing to know is that processing tasks may not always take the same amount of time each scan because of periodic communication or retries or conditional statements in your program. The scan buffer, set in the CR Basic scan instruction, allows processing tasks to be stored in a queue and then processed when the processor becomes available. This is what it looks like when the data logger doesn't complete all the tasks in a scan and the buffer overflows. When the buffer overflows, all the tasks in the buffer are dropped at once, which will cause a skip scan for every buffer. In this example, we have three measurements with processing and one communication instruction, get variables. Let's look at how the measurement task processor, the processing task processor, and the scan buffers all work together in pipeline mode. Three measurements, A, B, and C, are made. The three raw measurement values are held in the buffer until they can be processed. The get variable instruction runs successfully. It retrieves a variable from another data logger. There is some time left in the scan, which allows the processing task to begin working through the tasks queued in the buffer. Precisely one scan interval, 6 seconds in this example, after the first measurements were taken, they are taken again. Simultaneously, additional measurements that were left in the buffer are processed. The three new raw measurements are put into the buffer. The get variables instruction runs again, but this time it is not successful, resulting in retries. Meanwhile, the next scan begins precisely one scan interval after the previous measurements, and the measurements are taken again. Simultaneously, get variables continues. This time it is successful. The data logger processes as much as it can from the buffer. Note that C2 is still left in the buffer. It hasn't been processed. The measurement task detects that the processing has not read out all the values in the buffer. So the measurement task stops and signals to processing that it was unable to write new values. The buffer is emptied. Skip scans occur. The measurement and processing tasks are synchronized and restarted. Make three measurements, A, B, and C, and hold them in the buffer. The get variables instruction runs and is successful. The processing task begins working through the buffer. Precisely one scan interval after the previous measurements were taken, they are taken again. Simultaneously, additional processing that was left in the buffer takes place. If you see your skip scans increase by the same number regularly when viewing the station status, you are likely experiencing this. To eliminate skip scans, you can increase the number of scan buffers, increase the scan rate, or change the structure of your program. The Campbell Scientific website has several articles on skip scans and how to prevent them. Links to several of these articles are found in the description of this video. In pipeline mode, the data logger uses a minimum of two buffers. The previous example used just one for demonstration purposes. Now let's see what this looks like when using two buffers. We have three measurements with processing and one additional processing instruction, get variables. This time we have two buffers. Make three measurements, A, B, and C. The three raw measurement values are held in the buffer until they can be processed. The get variables instruction runs and is successful. There is some time left in the scan, so processing tasks can now begin working through the buffer. Precisely one scan interval, 6 seconds in this example, after the first measurements were taken, they are taken again. Simultaneously, additional measurements that were left in the buffer are processed. The three raw measurements are put into the buffer. The get variables instruction runs, but is not successful this time. Get variables begins to retry. Meanwhile, the next scan begins precisely one scan interval after the previous measurements, and the measurements are taken again. Simultaneously, get variables continues. This time, it is successful. The data logger processes as much as it can from the buffer. Note that C2 is left in the buffer. It hasn't been processed. The measurement task detects that processing has not read out all the values in the first buffer, so the latest measurement values are written to the second buffer. The get variables instruction runs and is successful. Processing continues by completing the processing from the first buffer. Make three measurements, A, B, and C, and hold them in the buffer. Simultaneously, additional measurements that were left in the buffer are processed. The get variables instruction runs and is successful. The processing task begins working through the buffer. Precisely one scan interval after the previous measurements were taken, they are taken again. Simultaneously, additional processing that was left in the buffer takes place. As I mentioned earlier, by default, your CR Basic program will try to compile in pipeline mode. That gives you the most precise measurement timing and usually more efficient processing and power consumption. CR Basic will automatically switch to sequential mode when necessary. Most notably, a program will compile in sequential mode when measurements will not be made every scan. For example, an if-then statement, or when measurements need to be set up externally. For example, the sensor needs to be powered by a switch 12-volt port. We've been looking at measurement and processing tasks in this video. Search for processing modes in the CR Basic help to see which tasks are considered measurement tasks and which are processing tasks. Visit our website, read the CR Basic help file, or contact Campbell Scientific if you have any questions about sequential and pipeline modes.